Also, for those of you guys that are interested in watching the Ricky Lake show, if you get it in your area, to my understanding, the show that I went to is going to be aired on the 11th, I think. I'm going to have to double check that. I will put it on my Facebook, but, yeah. And the name of the show is something in reference to stress relief or something like that. It's talking about stress. I can't really talk about it because, you know, once you sign your little declaration that you won't talk about it and put it on, you know, media networks and all that kind of stuff. So that's why I have not talked about that. Of course, I can't talk about business ventures or any of that. And for those of you guys that still don't understand that, that's unbelievable. I'm like, oh my God. I'm really starting to believe I have a lot of children that watch my channel. And this is not a kid's channel. This is for all adults right here. Because some of the questions and things that I get hit off with is juvenile. And I'm like, I'm really wondering, are these children that are tuning into my channel? Because full-fledged adults already know this already. There's certain things that you just can't do. And whenever you sign your document, I know somebody saying, Tina, don't do it. Well, I got to. When you sign your documents, okay, and what I did was I faxed mine at Staples because I had quite a bit of papers, as you can see, that I had to do and also run some copies and things. Oh, shit. My number all right there. Telephone number was all right there. But anyway, I went and faxed my documents at Staples. And when you have to do such things, I'll just show you a heading. Okay. Like this says, appearance release. I think I put this on my Facebook, but that was before. No, I didn't. Let me not even say that shit. I know my auntie seen them. I know Jody have seen them. But, you know, that's something that you just don't do, bitch. You get your shit shut down real motherfucking quick. When you are, and where does it say that at? I'm going to tell you. Because apparently some people just don't know that, and it's a shame. Well, I can't say that it's a shame, because what you don't know is what you don't know. But, I agree that the producer may film, tape, or photograph me and record my voice, conversations, and sounds, including any performance of any musical composition and other refrain from using my name, likeness. Okay. I acknowledge and agree that any and all information disclosed to or obtained by me concerning or relating to the program, and including but not limited to the premises and concept of the programming, the nature of certain events in the programming, my participation in the programming, as well as activities occurring in connection with the programming, and the outcome of the programming collectively, the confidential information shall be strictly confidential, and I hereby agree not to disclose any such confidential information to any individual or entity. So, which means, for those of you guys that don't get it or don't understand, okay, let me tell you a little bit about the entertainment business that a lot of people don't really know. Okay, first of all, when you are, the one thing you don't do as a cardinal sin is you don't name drop. And, you know, I try to refrain from that, and that is why he is considered as Mr. Malibu. He's known, a lot of people know who he is, but you guys know who he is too, but you guys just don't know, you know, you guys just don't know that we know each other. Let me just say that. And we are very close to each other. That's just something that you don't do. You don't do that for the simple fact that this is not nobody's channel but Tina's, okay? I'm not going to, and I can't say it enough, and I know some people right now, why are you still, because there's some people that don't get it. So for those of you guys that got it and understand, hold on 1 second, put your hands down. Let me answer the questions for people that don't get it, okay? For those of you guys that don't get it and or don't understand, you do not, when you are, you know, I don't want to say parlaying, but, you know, that's what came to the dome. When you are parlaying, shaking hands, embracing, having a couple of cocktails, hanging out, getting butted or what, however way y'all roll, you do not name drop. You don't say, oh, okay, well, guess what? I was with Boop that Whoop 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 last night, nigga. We was blowing. We was doing this right here. We fucked around, went to the dispensary, nigga. We got top shit. You don't do that. That's not what you do. You don't do that. Now, I mentioned Michael because I, you know, and I know that probably, some people probably felt that it was wrong, but that was a friend of mine. Contrary to what y'all motherfuckers might want to, well, some people get it, some people don't. I don't have shit to prove, but, you know, somebody that he was a man that I knew. It wasn't a sexual thing. Never was. You know, I don't do strange flesh. Not saying that he was strange flesh, because he really wasn't. He was somebody that I knew, you know what I'm saying, you know, on a certain type of level or whatever. But, you know, one thing you don't do, ladies, in this business here, when you start fucking around with the entertainment business, nigga, your shit will go all bad real quick if you real freely with your pussy. Let me just say that right the fuck right now. That is not going to get you nowhere. By sleeping with a lot of motherfuckers? No. You don't do that. Now, you know at the bottom line is niggas wants to, you know, niggas want a little piece of that. You know that already going in. But, you know, you get more shit going on when you don't sleep with a man. When you don't sleep with him, baby, you get perks like you would not fucking, shout out to the motherfucking, Rotiro. Got my little things on here now. I got, you know, dialed her up and everything. And then I even got, like the present, because it was a gift. So I got the little present, decal too on my, pool. And it's like a little gift box. It's so cute. But, so yeah. And then I have, so, you know, I just dolled her up and went and got the little decals and things that go on her that, you know, that was appropriate for her. But, yeah, when you don't sleep with a man, it's better than sleeping with him. Because once you sleep with a man, it changes up the dynamics of the relationship. As long as he kind of like, damn, I wonder what that's like, you win it. Because it's like, you know, he wants to know what to do, but, you know, you keep the motherfucker at bay. Not saying that Mr. Malibu, because I know you watching this, baby, but, I know what it is. But, you know, when you don't sleep with a man, they treat you differently than once you start sleeping with them. When you ain't sleeping with them, baby, they get to open up car doors and being extra nice and taking you to dinner and whoop that whoop. But once you start sleeping with that motherfucker, baby, get in the car so we can go. You know, they get to, you know, they want to handle you a little bit differently. So don't sleep with these motherfuckers. That's the problem. Because motherfuckers seem to believe that they shit is so tight and they shit is on deck. Oh, shit, once I get this nigga bar this right here, shit, I got this nigga stuck. You can't get no nigga stuck with your pussy. You cannot. And I'm so sick and tired of hearing that, you know, women, well, you know, and now I think it's more young women believe that they little twat or slit or whatever y'all want to call it, pocketbook, whatever. You know, they thinking that, you know, once I give him this right here, nigga, it's a wrap. This nigga finna start signing checks. Oh, I got keys to the house, car keys, motherfucking office, this and that, nigga, and this and that, insurance policy and all that. No, nigga. No. No, you don't sleep with him. You don't sleep with a motherfucker until you already know what it is in the first place. Okay, nigga, what we doing? Okay, is we, are we just kicking it? Or are we talking to, you know, kind of go towards being in a relationship? Or are we just bullshit? You need to establish what the shit it is from the start. If you don't realize what it is from the start, nigga, why is you fucking him? And in the back of the car, and you know, over there at his mama's house in the garage, and in the basement of uncle's house and all that, what are you doing? I mean, where they... Ladies, I can't say it enough. Your pussy is not going to keep a man faithful. It's not going to do it. Men are faithful when they want to be. When they deem you as, okay, well, you know what? I'm ready to just settle the fuck down. I'm tired of all these shenanigans and this bullshit. I'm ready to just settle down with this motherfucker. Right? It comes from him. It don't come from you. I don't give a fuck how many goddamn briskets and shit you cooking. I don't give a damn how you spending your EBT card on Alaskan King Crab and motherfucking porterhouse steaks and all that shit. Nigga, and pussy on the side. It's not going to make that man be faithful. It's not going to do it. Now, what does make him, you know, relax and shit is when you get up in his motherfucking head. When you get up in his head and his heart and shit, and, you know, and you, you know, show some form of value system. Whereas, you know, nigga, you ain't finna do that. No, I ain't finna let you know. Hell no, nigga, you ain't doing. That's when niggas start treating you a little bit differently. When they already know, okay, well, check this out. I can't really come at her like that because she ain't finna buy the bullshit. That's when shit changes. You know, so I say unto you young ladies that's out here and y'all dating and all that other kind of old shit, and even chicks my age, you out here dating dudes and shit and, you know, out here moonlighting or whatever or tipping or however way you want to call it or whatever, don't sleep with him. You get more shit that way. Because now he's striving to get the pussy. When you just give it to him, oh, nigga, no. It's all bad after that. Nigga don't even know who you are. You see the nigga in the store, he want to act like he don't see you. This nigga's all like he on the phone, ain't really nobody on there. You know, he's subject to drive by your ass, you know what I'm saying, and you're walking. All kind of old shit. Why? Because you done broke this nigga off, done probably sucked his dick nuts too. And now this nigga done lost respect for you, and it's like, you know what, bitch, I'm cool. So, I mean, you know, I mean, check it out. You know what I'm saying? Just look at y'all experiences, and look at when I gave up the pussy, and when I didn't. What I got while I was fucking him, what I got when I didn't. What's the problem? It should be an easy motherfucking thing. It should be easy. It should be easy. You should be able to see that and be like, you know what, nigga, I can read that shit with Braille. It should be easy. So, I can't say that enough. So, anyway, enough about that. Yesterday, how about... Okay, Isaiah came home. I helped Isaiah with his homework. He had his spelling words and shit. And, y'all, let me tell y'all some of the spelling words my baby, we was going over last night. Okay, and they had, corridor, turmoil, absorb, absurd, burrow. Nigga, he had, colonel. Predator, rehearse, shit. He had hanger and hangar. It's two different ones, of course. Yeah, he had some serious spelling words. And I was like, wow, my baby was getting it, too. I mean, he was really, really getting it. And then I got, and I appreciate you guys, you know, respecting the fact that your girl got different facets. I'm multifaceted, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I'll come over here and do a little bit of that. Go over there and do that. Cook you something. Sew you something. Bitch. Fuck like a motherfucking champion. You know what I'm saying? Excuse me. Come back to the light, Caroline. Come back. Yeah. So, you know, I mean, I can get out and do some different things. Man, I am not mad at motherfucking Magic Johnson and them. The Dodgers is looking to buy AEG, nigga. We got a football team coming. Holla. You know, when the Raiders left us, nigga, it was like, man, we was like, really, like, we didn't have no football team. But now, shit, we got the Farmer Stadium coming, and it's going to be right over there by the Staples Center, nigga. It's going to be off the chain. I know it's going to take a few years, though, for it to, you know, really crack off or whatever. And they was kind of talking about the Raiders coming back. Then they were saying the Chargers, we might get the Chargers down here. You know, different shit like that. So Magic Johnson and them is looking, nigga, what? You know, you know you got some long ass motherfucking money, nigga, when you out here buying a whole team. Fuck it, let me just buy this team right here. Let me just buy this whole motherfucking Staples Center. Because the Staples Center is for sale, too. So, the Staples Center is for sale, so they trying to sell that motherfucking Magic them, his crew. They done bought the Dodgers franchise. Now them niggas is trying to buy buy the, you know, man. I ain't mad at none of that. Get your coins, pesos, pounds, nigga, all that, yen, all that shit. Get it. Because I say right here, right now, if any of you guys had the opportunities that some other motherfuckers get, including myself, you would be doing it too. Now, I get motherfuckers coming here talking about, oh, well, Tina, I liked you better when you was talking shit. I liked you better when, you know, you was whoop that whoop. And why are you trying to be all Hollywood? And as long as they don't censor you down, baby, excuse me. If it was you, you'd be on some other shit too. Make no mistake, I got 3 motherfucking kids. I got one in college that he's trying to do on some biochemical engineering. Nigga, that costs cheddar. That costs cheese to put him through college on that right there. Yeah, that I got to pay for. You understand me? So, yeah, let me sign that, nigga, what? Okay, you need me to fax it to what number? Okay, no problem. Okay, let me read that through. Okay, yeah. Boop, the boop, 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 boop. Fax number is area code 212, boop, the boop, boop, boop. Yeah. No problem. So don't judge me. Because I'm on a mission. Shit, I'm trying to buy these condos for my kids and shit. I'm trying to buy some extra houses and shit. Nigga, I'm trying to do something. Y'all don't even know. I'm trying, you know, and I get motherfuckers coming on here. Well, Tina, why don't you, you know, have, you know, do this and this and this. Open up a boutique. It's too many motherfuckers selling earring backs and motherfucking shit. I don't want that. I mean, it's too much of it. You know, I mean, it's only so much motherfucking shit that you can say. You know what I mean? It's like, well, Tina, why don't you sell jewelry and basketball wise earrings? Nigga, that shit is played to me. That shit is played out to me. You know what I mean? I mean, I don't like, me personally, when I see everybody gravitating to one thing, I'm the nigga that steer away from it. When I see a whole lot of something, I don't want that. Give me the timeless shit. Give me the shit that don't, you know what I'm saying? That don't go out of style or whatever. You know, I like shit that's timeless. And so, you know, when everybody is gravitating to, like that ombre, I didn't really like the little ombre get down and, you know, motherfuckers was on the basketball wife earrings and shit. My girl made me a couple pair of them or whatever. You know, I wore them a couple times and shit. But I'm not really into it. You know, I'm not really, give me some timeless shit. I like I like hoop earrings, but you know, I got some hoop earrings that, you know what I'm saying, them motherfuckers is glittering all around them motherfuckers, and they real. Because, you know, motherfuckers, ghetto motherfuckers, excuse me. And I had a bitch ask me, too, oh, I really like those earrings. Are they real? It's like, who asked that? I mean, where they do that at, bitch? I mean, I get motherfuckers asking, is that purse real? I done been asked that. I get asked, is my hair real? Especially, see, you know, motherfuckers that be, because I wear my shit all raggedy, you know, twisted all up and all that. Motherfuckers be, and then too, they don't, you know, motherfuckers be like, damn, that's really her hair. Because motherfuckers is really, you know, trying to own the wig shit and all that shit. They should be all, nigga, I'm flat ironing this with ceramic, this and that. Nigga, I won this, that, that. Me, nigga, put my shit up in a bun like this right here and I'm cool. I'm not a glamour chick. I'm not one of them chicks that got to get up every day and put on all this motherfucking rouge and all that shit. No. Give me some eyelashes and I'm cool. And the reason why I wear my eyelashes is because one of my motherfucking eyes, this motherfucker be on some Uncle Ruster type of, this motherfucker just be big and shit. I'm like, so it's like, is it Uncle Ruster? Well, y'all know the Boondocks, the motherfucker with the big ass eye and shit. So it's like when I look at my shit and I'm like, you know what, nigga, put some eyelashes on because that motherfucking eye just bulges. And I think it has something to do with my thyroid. It is what the fuck it is. It is what it is. I don't really give a damn, but, you know, hey. So, me, give me some eyelashes and I'm cool. Oh, shit, y'all. How about... y'all know that we legal over here in the state of California on the cannabis shit. Yesterday, they passed the shit because they was trying to shut our shit down, nigga. And, it didn't work. They, keep the candy shops rolling. Shit, they talking about that shit on the news right now. We winning. I was talking to Jeremy yesterday, y'all. Me and Jeremy was cool. That's my dude. Straight out of Chicago. Comments on my videos all the time. I fucked around and gave him my number. I called him one day or whatever. This, you know, around the time his mom had passed. And then he's a Virgo too, so we really relate and shit. And I called that motherfucker up one night and shit. And, you know, kind of threw that nigga for a loop. But, you know, and then, you know, he was like, ain't Tina called me. Whoop, 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 whoop. You know, he was like, I can't believe you called my number. Yeah, nigga, I called you. I calls people. You know, especially when people leave me their numbers and stuff. I'll just surprise your ass and call you one day like, excuse me, Vicky, how you doing? Because I'm calling your ass next. I'm calling you. I've been meaning to call you, but I just haven't. I know that I'm supposed to, you know, do what I told you I was going to do. I'm going to do that. But your girl just been a little bit busy. I'm getting your messages. When you going to do that? I got it, mama. I got it. And then I had, I'm not going to talk about that other shit because I'm just going to do what I'm going to do because then therefore motherfuckers will be waiting like, didn't you say you was going to do this right here? So, on this thing, I've realized now that I'm never going to say what it is that I'm going to do because motherfuckers is looking for you to do just that when you said you was going to do it. Fuck the fact that you got all that shit over there going on. I still need you to do this right here because you said you was going to do it. Like, I ain't got three dogs. Like, I ain't got three goddamn children. Like, I ain't trying to run multiple households and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't got shit going on in the background that I done signed on for. Like, I ain't got nothing else to do. You know what I'm saying? Oh, but you, bitch, you said you was going to do this right here, so I'm just trying to figure out, bitch, where the video at. I got motherfuckers like, nigga, where's the cornbread, video? I mean, nigga, can we get some goulash? I mean, what's happening? Philly steak, sandwich video, what the videos at? What are cooking at? What we sewing? Family, I'm just one motherfucker. I got an assistant now, though. I got an assistant to help me with my email, and I got an executive assistant to help me with other aspects of my life. You know, other things like yesterday, I get my house clean now on Tuesdays and Thursdays, okay? I had since dropped the lady that was doing my house before because some couple, you know, let me just say that. I don't want to, boop, come, bring that back, okay? Because, you know, anyway. So I had one lady that was working on my, that was cleaning my house. I no longer have her. I have another lady come on Tuesdays and Thursdays. So yesterday, I had the house cleaned. Nigga, how about I was laid up in this motherfucker posted? I was like, I was in this motherfucker chilling, just like right chill. I was cool. Shit, I was in this motherfucker posted the fuck up, watching from Wendy to shit, Ricky Lake, all the motherfuckers. I was in here chilling. So I don't have to do any more housework right now, and I'm loving that shit. I don't have to wash no dishes. I don't have to do any of that, and I'm loving that shit. So, yeah, so that's one thing that's going on. I am doing a video on how to clean your purses. I started on that video over the weekend, as well as doing a video on my bed of nails. Because, okay, you know how, like, on your purses, the patina changes, you know? And, like, I'm loving the character that is taking on now. Now, one thing about the real purses, one thing I can say about the real purses is, this don't peel off. You know, like on the fake ones, this shit get the peeling off around the handles and shit. Like now, from me holding it. And y'all, how about Kenny had the nerve to hold my goddamn purse like this? Y'all, let me tell you something. Nigga, I freaked out. I like, nigga, don't you hold my purse like that because he carries my purses. My purse be heavy. Now, this purse here now, she's about, I want to say about 6 pounds. But when I throw my iPad in there and all my keys and my wallet, my auntie got me a wallet. So when I throw my wallet and all that shit in there, nigga, it gets heavy. Let me see. My auntie got me a wallet, and then before she had got, and she had got me a checkbook cover. How cute is that? So I got the checkbook cover, the wallet, and the bag. And so it's like now that it's a trip because when I went to the DMV, I had to go renew my license. My license expired on my birthday. And so they had sent me a form back in the end of July saying that I didn't have to retest because I hadn't had any accidents or any points on my license or no tickets or none of that. Let me knock on motherfucking wood, bitch. Pull over, please. Let me knock on wood for some shit come. But anyway, so, you know, and so I let the shit expire. They talking about Nicki Minaj, this bitch. I cannot believe you, bitch. You beside your motherfucking self. It's a trip how you help motherfuckers get on, and then, you know, motherfuckers wasn't really checking for your ass at first, but then a motherfucker helped put your ass out there, and then you turn on the very bitch that try to help your ass, nigga. That's crazy. Boo, bitch. Boo! Oh, my God. They showing this shit on TMZ right now. I cannot believe this bitch just showed the fuck out. Bitch, you lost all kind of points. Yo, nigga, your stock went down. Boo, bitch. Boo. They showing this shit, nigga. I don't even want to see it. Anyway, but, you know, so it's like now when I go to the bathroom or, you know, when I'm in the restaurant or I'm in the market, you know, I notice, you know, women looking at my purse and it's like, okay, I'm noticing what they're looking at. But what I'm going to do, because this purse is rather expensive, so, and I'm like, you know, I don't want to be carrying my purse and the motherfucker just smack my shit and get to running because I can't catch you. You know what I'm saying? Bitch ain't fast. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no speed on. So, you know, what I'm going to do is I'm going to wear my other Louis Vuitton purse, and it is also real. I have the Deville, D-E-A-U-V-I-L-L-E. Deville. I've always called it Deville. Anyway. But I have another one, and she's a little bit smaller than this one. And I begin to clean her up and clean up the patina and all that other kind of stuff, and, you know, and all this, the viscera and all that. I begin to clean it up. So, and I was going to do a video about it. I cleaned one side. One side is all the way clean, and the other side isn't, to show you guys the difference on how to clean them. I am going to do a video about that. All the stuff is already set up at Ken's house. I have a tripod at Ken's house and everything to do the videos, some videos at his house and some videos at my house. I know that I'm backed up on video. I know that. But, you know, I got a lot going on at once. So, but anyway, I've noticed that chicks look at my purse when I'm out and about. You know, motherfuckers want to see if your shit's real. Especially black women. It's a trip. I went to go get my toenails done. I got the little French tip manicure. Let me show y'all what's happening. Can you see that? I don't have no ugly feet. I ain't got no bunions, no corns. My shit don't go overlapping. I don't wear shoes where my shit is over the top. I don't put an acrylic on my big toe. None of that ghetto shit. I don't do none of that. So anyway, I went and I got me a spa pedicure. And that particular day, I was changing out my purse while she was doing my feet. I was changing from my little coach bag over to, you know, Miss Retiro. So, anyway, so the Asian chick, she just looking at my purse, you know what I'm saying? Because they like Louis and Gucci and shit. So, you know, she checking out my shit, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, she was fucking that language up to her partners, you know what I'm saying? So, I don't know what the fuck they were saying about me. But it was like, you know, whatever it was, they was fucking that language up. So, I'm just, you know, going through my purse and I'm taking out everything. And, you know, I was, you know, telling you guys on Facebook, oh, how about auntie gave me a wallet and woo, 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 woo. Anyway, so I was sitting there and I was, you know, going through my little things or whatever. They was fucking that language up. So I know what they were saying. Is that purse real? And woo, 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 is that purse real? But wait a minute. How about one of them had the audacity to come over and come pick up my purse? And she looked at my shit through and through. She looked at it. She wanted to look at the... You know, she's like, oh, very, very nice. Oh, nice, nice. oh, Betty, nah. And I'm sitting up here looking at this bitch, y'all. Y'all know I'm going to cuss this bitch out. But you know what? I was like, you know, let this bitch go ahead on, you know, take a gander this right here. Because this bitch was on some, oh, Betty, Betty, nice. Oh, my God. $2,000, huh? $2,000? And I just looked at this motherfucker. She was looking at it all through and through, looked at the bottom and shit. Because one thing about Louis Vuitton, the shit adds up. You know, like when you look at the patterns, now unless you have the, can't think of the name of that bag, and I want one of those too. I want that Speedy 40. Okay, with the Speedy 40, it's one strip of material. So on one end, all of the LVs are going down, but as it turn around and go up, it flips around because it's one piece of material that goes all the way around. Well, on this particular bag, you know, and one thing about Louis as well as Coach as well, at the seams, the patterns stay the same. That's one way you could tell when your Coach is real, because your patterns will stay the same. It will all run concurrent. And so on here, okay, you see how it has the LVs and then it has like the little clover or whatever that is? All of the shit just adds up. And though this is separate pieces of material, because this is a whole separate panel. So anyway, so she was looking at my purse, very, very nice. Oh my God, $2,000? Oh, very nice. Very, very nice. She was looking at my shit through and through. I said, yeah, bitch, go and check that out. Yeah, baby sent that to me. Birthday. Check it out. Because she was really thinking that my shit wasn't real. So I guess that bitch thought she was getting a $3 tip or whatever. No, bitch, because I didn't like the way you got out at the end. So take this right here. So, but anyway, but yeah. Yeah. But I find now that a lot of women really, you know, women and especially women that are, you know, versed about such things, they really be looking at your shit. Because on the fake ones, the patina doesn't change. The leather doesn't change. Now, you see, now it's starting to take on a real caramel type look to it now. You know, where I'm holding the handles at. It's darkening up, you know, there's double stitching. I mean, you could, the workmanship on these motherfuckers is cold-blooded. And it's like, buying a bag such as this is like an investment. This is an investment bag, a bag that I would have the rest of my life. You know, and it's like, you know, I don't know, man. Baby, thank you so much. Thank you. I can't thank you enough. So, I just love her. And every time I look at her, I think about you because it's like, man, look what you did for me. Not to say that you don't do beautiful things for me, because you do. And, I mean, I still have all my little stuff over there that you sent me. Beautiful. Y'all, he sent me beautiful candles. I mean, just... And then for Christmas last year, how about he donated some money on my behalf to a charitable... you know, to a charity and stuff. He did a charitable contribution in my honor, in my name. And I'm like, how fucking bomb is this? Who does? Nigga, you ain't finna get that from Rick Rock and them. Them niggas ain't doing that. Lil Boosie and all them niggas, they ain't doing that shit, nigga. They want some pussy fur. They ain't finna do none of that kind of shit. You know, and it's like, you know, how beautiful is that? I mean, you're just a man of something else. I don't even know what to say about you. I don't know what to say. Every time I look at that, I think about you, and it's just beautiful.